intelligence correspondent Catherine Herridge is at the D.C. District Court tonight with the latest. Good evening, Catherine.
Right, General Flynn is now required to fully cooperate, and that raises the stakes for President Trump, his son-in-law Jared Kushner, and other members of his inner circle.
After 33 years of military service, including 5 years in combat, retired general and former national security advisor Mike Flynn stood composed before a federal judge and pled guilty to a felony lying to the FBI. Democrats praised the plea as a milestone.
There is broader exposure of other people within the transition team and possibly within the administration. So I don't think we've seen the end of this.
With his wife in the front row, Flynn told the judge he willingly and knowingly waived his right to a trial by his peers. And as part of the deal, Flynn will fully cooperate with Special Counsel Robert Mueller's Russia investigation. 4 days after the inauguration, newly unsealed court records show Flynn sat down with FBI agents and during the interview misled them about his contact with Russian Ambassador Sergei Kislyak. Legal experts said the plea deal may be a stepping stone to targets inside the White House.
It turns up the pressure on other individuals. It causes people in the White House to wonder what's coming next, who's going to go next. And I think all of that is designed to get cooperation from these people and for Mueller to send a signal to the White House that he's here playing hardball.
Republicans disagreed.
I've seen no evidence at all indicating that there's any connection between General Flynn and the president, anything involving Russian collusion.
In a statement, Flynn said, "It has been extraordinarily painful to endure months of false allegations of treason and other outrageous acts." Flynn said what he did was wrong, and through his faith, he would set things right.
By pleading, he's admitted the falsity of it, the materiality of it, and the intent to deceive. That's different from what Director Comey told us on HPC earlier this year.
A source close to the matter tells Fox News that in late spring, then FBI Director James Comey told Congress in closed-door testimony his agents concluded Flynn had not deliberately misled them about the Russia contacts. Rather, Flynn was confused about the timeline and overwhelmed by a chaotic transition. On Twitter, Comey posted part of a Bible verse about justice.
A source close to Flynn tells Fox News that he's in the process of selling a house to help pay back legal bills. And it was the financial and emotional pressure that helped crystallize his decision to cut a deal and cooperate in order to avoid several more years of crippling litigation, Brett.
Catherine, thank you.
A Fox News alert, an avalanche of news today. We'll get to the stunning Steinle verdict out in San Francisco in just a moment. But we begin with the breaking new developments on the Mueller investigation in Washington. Today, former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn appeared in federal court and pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI about his conversations with Russia's ambassador during the transition last December. His plea agreement indicates he is providing information to the special counsel that's advancing the investigation. Chief Intelligence Correspondent Catherine Herridge was inside the courtroom earlier and joins us now with the very latest details. Anything new, Catherine, since we spoke at 2 o'clock?
Well, one of the most interesting developments comes out of reporting by another one of our colleagues, Brett Baer. We were able to get information that in the spring of this year, FBI Director James Comey testified in a closed-door session that his agents had concluded that Flynn made some sort of bad decisions or didn't remember things properly, seemed kind of confused about the timeline of events in December, but they didn't believe he had deliberately misled them. That's significant because if you fast forward to today, about 7 months later, the special counsel investigators under Robert Mueller have concluded something very different, that there was a deliberate effort by Flynn to mislead the FBI about Flynn's contacts with the Russian ambassador. And Flynn agreed in court today. What I would say about his appearance in court today is that he was very composed. He seemed to really reach inside himself and have that soldier's discipline. And that 33 years of service in the military allowed him to hold it together as he made that guilty plea, which is a felony. The other interesting thing we're looking at tonight is that in the court records that were unsealed, there are references to what appear to be two members of the Trump transition team, a more junior person who received information from Flynn at Mar-a-Lago in December about these conversations with the Russian ambassador. We believe that to be KT McFarland at this point, and then a more senior person who was directing Flynn to reach out to a number of countries, including Russia, and we believe that to be Jared Kushner. But I would give you this caveat. We were told that it wasn't like Kushner was saying to Flynn, you go out and just talk to the Russians. it was a kind of divvying up of the phone calls. There were different teams for different countries, and they were all tasked with a certain amount of outreach at that time. So it's not quite as sort of sinister sounding, perhaps, as it is in the black and white of the court documents. But we believe the very senior person was Jared Kushner, and that he testified to that in his session with the special counsel in November, Dana.
All right, Catherine Herridge, thanks so much. We'll take it
around
the table. I worked at the Justice Department for about a year and know to approach these things with caution. So I'm just waiting to see what else is going to happen out of this. I don't think that we know the full story yet. What do you think, Greg?
Well, I always like to focus on the media. And the media, they remind me of a contestant on Price is Right. They were expecting a brand new car, which was Russian collusion, and instead they got a crock pot, which is a lie, a single crime committed by pleading guilty to it, a single isolated event that has nothing to do with Russian collusion because it happened after the election. So they said the ecstatic media is going to be ecstatic for a few days, but then it's going to wear off, and they're going to realize that this is a far cry from what they really wanted, and they're actually seeding turf on this, that this is far from what they dreamt. But what really bugs me about this is if you look at why the meeting took place, why were the contacts made, was it anything nefarious? No, it was something noble and possible. I mean, something, in my opinion, noble and correct, was to get Russia involved in fighting terror and fighting ISIS, and actually their version of a reset button that actually made kind of sense, which we may or may not have happened, I don't know. But that's what this was about, in my opinion. Yeah. Tucker, you're giving me that weird look you give people on your show.
Sorry. I'm actually agreeing with everything you say. I think the irony...
But no, you say that to the people you're about to yell at. You say, I agree completely.
But in this case, it's heartfelt. No, I actually think that General Flynn did do something wrong. In fact, indefensible. He took money from a foreign government to influence American policy when he was on his way to being national security advisor from the Erdogan government in Turkey. I don't think you can defend that. I'm ashamed that he did that. Mm-hmm. And that's not what he's being punished for. He's being punished for lying, which is the classic charge you level when you don't really have the underlying charge proved. But more to the point, is there a crime in contacting Russia to talk about how to coordinate your efforts in Syria against ISIS? That seems not just...
But maybe he's getting the chance to do this guilty plea because
for sure.
of something
there's
else.
A lot
I mean, there's a lot.
No, but I guess what bugs me is the idea that speaking to Russia is in itself
a crime.
I don't think that's what the prosecuting documents are saying. I think
What are they saying?
The prosecuting documents saying that he lied to the FBI, number one. And I think they use that as sort of a carrot and stick to say, we will charge you for just this one crime so you could tell us what else you know. And in his statement to the press, he indicated, I plan on working, fully cooperating with the special counsel.
I got it, but what would the underlying crime be? I'm just confused.
We don't know that yet, because it's still sealed. And not to mention the fact that when you are a transitioning government, when the Obama administration was still the government in control, talking to a foreign agency about what you will and will not do is against the Logan Act, which is the act that says only one administration can talk to a foreign government at one time.
Right.
So he did violate a law, but we'll have to see what Mueller does here.
But how is it any more different than when Obama said, I'll have more flexibility after, you know, the election? I mean, I think that Greg brings up a really great...
When did he say that?
Obama said
hot
that.
Mic.
Hot mic moment.
What do you mean,
hot
how
mic.
Is it any different?
Well, what I mean is that it's a transition, and they're signaling to these people on these other countries that, you know, policies are going to change. I think that Greg brings up a really good point about...
I often do, Rachel. Thank you very much.
I guess
you passed your first show.
That's my first test.
That's all it takes.
You got to agree with Greg.
That's all it takes. But I think you bring up a point. There is a giddiness, kind of like the giddiness we saw with Rachel Maddow when she thought she had the big taxes thing. I think you're right. They got a crockpot here because in the end, what they really want to do is not Russia. What they really want to do is stop the Trump agenda. And Trump was just a vehicle for this agenda. The American people still want all the things that Trump wants to do. They still want those policies and those ideas to come forward. So whether all this Russia stuff happens or not, I think it leads the Democrats, again, down this little street off of what they need to do. And what they need to do is figure out why they lost working class Americans. Because we know that's why they lost the election, not Russia.
So, Rachel, I'll give you that. And I've said that before. I think Democrats need to work on our messaging. We need to learn how to talk to blue-collar voters and some white-collar voters. And I'm not an impeachment Democrat. I'm not like, let's go impeach them. I'm actually waiting for all the facts to come out. I've said that over and over again. But when you look at where we are right now, the fact that Mike Flynn, one of the highest officials in Donald Trump's national security apparatus has said he is going to work with the special counsel prosecuting or looking into this Russia collusion. I think that's a big deal. Well, I think to downplay that is silly.
Wait, no, slow down. Is that what he said? I'm going to look into collusion with Russia? Collusion about what? The context that we know of took place.
It is a Russia investigation.
Let me just finish my question to you, and then you can inform me of this. What would the collusion look like, potentially?
I have no idea. That's a quote we're trying to figure out.
No, but this is, I think...
After the election.
It was after the election, so what would they be colluding on exactly?
Here's the thing, it doesn't matter.
Well, that's how this started. The whole premise was about the election, but they really don't care about the election. This is about unseating a president.
I have to say that that's just not true, because if you look at all the... You're looking at the Flynn indictment in a vacuum, and you can't do that. You have to look at Flynn, you have to look at Papadopoulos, you have to look at Manafort. Manafort was indicted for things that happened during the convention prior to the election. Papadopoulos, he was in meetings prior to the election. So let's, before we sit here and say, oh, you can't look at Flynn in a vacuum.
But I'm not saying that. I'm just asking you what it means. What are you saying?
I don't know. Okay. And that's what Dana's saying. We don't know what it means. We have an expert prosecutor, the best in the country, looking at this.
What might it mean? Like, what's the worst case scenario?
I don't want to make any assumptions. Okay. I don't
totally
know.
What I think...
How are you confused?
They rigged the Sochi Olympics. That's what we're going to find out.
No. I'm sorry. I don't think there's any confusion to be had here. I think what Mueller is looking into, whether or not Trump and his associates talk to the Russians, work with the Russians, colluded with the Russians.
About what?
We all already know that the Russians engaged in our election and they jeopardized our democracy, number one.
We don't know that.
Yes, we do. The DNI said, and multiple intelligence agencies over and over have said, that the Russians tried to compromise our election. That is a fact.
Can I tell you what Trump really is guilty of?
It's not a fact, Richard.
It is a fact.
Trump is guilty of bad judgment. A lot of people told him not to give that very high-level position to Flynn. But this is a very common rookie mistake. Dana, you know this. You're in politics, in that... a lot of candidates, first-time candidates. Remember, we're talking about a first-time candidate. He's our president, but he's a first-time candidate. You feel very loyal to the people that brought you, to victory. And so I think Trump had a very typical first candidate mistake of giving a job to somebody who was on the campaign who probably shouldn't have that job. And look, he only lasted 20-some days, so they reversed course
He was lobbying for the Turkish government.
Right, he should not
have. So that's totally disqualifying. And I just want to be clear, I'm not defending Flynn. Appalling. I wish he were being punished for the actual crime.
Thank you.
But maybe the reason that he's not being punished for the actual crime is for some reason that we don't know.
Well,
this is why this takes a long time. It might be wrapped up sooner than we think, but remember, it was also President Obama who told President Trump, be careful of this guy. Right. It's Sally Yates who goes to them at the White House, goes to the White House from the Justice Department and says, I think you guys have a problem here. She gets fired. The president's calling for Comey to go easy on Flynn. That's how they end up with the special counsel. I don't know how all of this pulls together, but it's certainly not nothing. And by the way, I agree, nothing here when you're calling to Russia to say, hey, make sure we have established contact, no problem. Somebody like Mike Flynn, who is a seasoned patriot, 33 years in the military, why lie about that? That's the thing that I don't understand, but he pled guilty to it today.
Isn't the FBI also...
Because they're threatening him.
Why isn't Mueller also, or do we know if he is?
No, but why the underlying, though? Why lie?
Why lie?
They're threatening him. Tucker. So
let me put it this way. Why lie? I haven't the faintest idea, but I do know, having known a number of people who've been busted on the lying to a federal agent thing, and I don't want to appear to be defending someone I just attacked for lobbying for Turkey, but we are vesting far too much trust in the FBI. Do you have any idea what it looks like when they come after you? Do you know anyone who's been gone after by the FBI?
Very well.
I was a spokesperson for several years. Question is, I like the FBI and I support American law enforcement, but which is potentially a greater threat to you, Mike Flynn or the FBI? It's not a close call. So I don't think we should just assume that because someone has pled to lying that there's an actual crime in that.
And he said he's a broken man. His house is under, he's selling his house. His finances are in trouble. These are all very good motivations to, cooperate.
All right. Well, I think we're going to finish that up, right? Okay, much more.